Come on, someone cap it. No one's here. Oh, they're kind of shooting each other down. Well, that's unfortunate. Maybe we'll fly straight. We'll give them the opportunity to hit us. Oh! What a shot. The game was going to end anyway. That was amazing. All right, ladies and gentlemen, Baron here. So we're going to be taking a part in the Road of the Brave. So basically, what has to happen here is the enemy here has to land on this airfield with gear down, and we have to shoot them down. So we do get artillery, which is kind of cool, and man, we just switched gears and really took off right there. So it's basically a race to make sure that the enemy doesn't land. So let's see, that is that side. Let's try to drop artillery, because that lag's getting awfully low. Man, this thing is moving. So they've got to cap it. You can use machine guns, you can use... Oh, I think we artilleryed the wrong side. No, we didn't. We shouldn't have. This is a really cool idea for a battle mode because it's silly and it's fun. And I think War Thunder needs more of that. It's just silly funness. Alright, so... They can bomb. Oh, shit. Oh, how did we miss that? Oh, he got wrecked. Okay. Oh, my God. Guy had landing flaps and everything down. Incoming. All right, so they're taking, like, massively evasive maneuvers. Oh, we got a hit. Now, was that a machine gun or the main gun? Oh, they capped it? How did they get that? So who's played this game mode? What do you think of it? Now, this is first time, and it's kind of hectic. I don't know what's going on, but my main gun is not working, it seems. Or I'm just absolutely missing. We're getting knackered by the enemy machine guns. How did they cap this? Is there someone still on it? I wonder if there's, like, you don't actually have to land, you just fly over it. I should have read the directions a little more in depth. Let's try AP rounds. So how's everyone's 4th of July weekend going if you are celebrating it? We probably could have taken the LVT out because you've got those two rear gunners. You can easily turn around. Come on, get a hit. I think we... Come on, we need them flying a straight line. And get a... We need to get a shell hit. Look at this pro. Oh, there we go. We got our first kill. Okay, I'm pretty sure we just coaxial machine gun the pilot right out of that. But, yep, so I have been streaming. If you guys have been... Oh, this is awesome. Oh, that was awesome. I have been streaming on twitch.tv/BaronVonGames. We've been playing a lot of Total War Warhammer. And you probably saw today's video, the special edition. Oh, that guy just looked like he was about to crash. Hitting these guys. Oh, here we go. Enemy kill assist, we'll take it. All right, so they're not capping right now. It's just taking pot shots. We're running out of ammunition. Now, HE rounds would be better once they did hit the enemy aircraft, but as far as, like, trying that... Alright. I don't know if they have as good of, like, a trajectory. That was a main cannon hit. That had to have been. Two X hit. Dude, our transmission's beat up. Shit is not going well. Oh, here we go. Low flying lag. I'm pretty sure some of these planes can do pretty well with penetration. Like, I think the lag 3's, 50 cal, it's 12.7, should have enough. So I'm gonna guard this side. Oh. Engines damaged, two of the crew are bleeding out. All right. We'll repair. Got an assist on that with the Panzer IIIB. Dude, I have not driven the Panzer IIIB. That's one of the few vehicles I think I've never played. Might have to check that one out. Oh! YOLO dive. So, I think this is a pretty cool idea. As far as the execution, obviously there's always room for improvement. In anything, really. Oh god, who's doing that? P-36G, you've got a 50 cal, dude. You got to be doing some work here, friend. Tat. What? We just hit that guy with our main gun. Holy crap, that was awesome. Ye've little faith. We turned away, though. Oh, what's up, friend? Now that Crusader would be a good tank to take out. Quick firing 40 mil, but I mean, this is a quick firing 37. Now that's who we should have been shooting at. Here we go. Aircraft destroyed though, we'll take it. So we're getting a few kills here. Enemy kill assist, why not? These planes are not doing a very good job at killing us, but they are doing a pretty damn good job at, Oh, wow, that guy got whacked. We're out of ammunition. So I'm gonna J out and see if the LVT is any better. Now, the LVT, however, is weaker, but with those two rear machine guns, but then we'd have to get up there. All the ammunition. 147 rounds. Alright. I love this skin. This is my, I just love it. It's like a little shark skin, but it's like cute. Yeah, so those two rear gunners in the back should help us out a lot. Oh! Come on. Come here, big boy. Let's do this. Oh, yeah. All right, boys. I'm enjoying this event. It's silly fun. And as I said earlier, so that's the thing, right? If you look at the War Thunder endgame, there's just too much of just, like, try hard, where, like, all the game is about is like, okay, I just need to go out and kill and grind and kill and grind. Got some hits. Let's whip this bad boy around when we get a little closer. So it looks like we're gonna win. I'm pretty sure the tanks are supposed to win. Got some hits. We may? Have we We lost one of our rear gunners. And being in an LVT, we're getting picked on. Which definitely makes sense. Supporting fire, how'd we do? 4 kills. We had someone who was an ace. Can we match it? Oh, we couldn't fire. We were on hand, though. So I'm going to try that one again and see how we're doing. So I'll go over the planes and just kind of like... Ooh, well, look at that. Earned a battle trophy. Lots of backups. So player stats. See, no wonder everybody's playing the tanks because the planes aren't being rewarded. See, this is one of those things where it's like a fun idea. They just need to have a little bit better of an execution on this. But it is the weekend. We do have a fun event. We do have enduring confrontation going on as well as tank sim battles. But now we have a fun event, which I've never seen before in my 4 years of playing this game. So you can take a lot of tanks. The only one I'm not sure is why the hell is the T-126 in here? Everything else is like low tier, low BR. And then there's one of the biggest troll tanks of all time, the T-126 in here. Now, it doesn't matter too much, but you can see that with the enemy planes, it's like the only bomber in there is the Po-2. Do we have a swordfish in there? We don't have the swordfish, but we do have the Po-2, which is fun. You know what? We could take part in the planes. We do have our Po-2 in our lineup, and then I think we'll get another plane and see what it's like on the enemy side. I think the lag 3. Let's look at this. Ground target rounds, 25 mils of penetration. Armored targets, here's what we want. Oh yeah, all right. So, a quick upgrade here. Baron, where do you get your golden eagles? I get them from the tears of my enemies. So we gotta upgrade our 20 so we can get the armored target 20 mil. And then I'm pretty sure we'll be able to mess some people up. Because most of these tanks can't hang. So ground target rounds, and then we'll have ground target rounds here, which is 25. Oh wait, this is the 20. All right, I wanted to do this one. This is pretty good armor penetration right here. And we've got the beloved Po-2. Now we just gotta put this thing in our lineup. And we're gonna take part in this event is Soviets. So hopefully this is quick. All right, so here it is. In this event, pilots should capture the road that is being controlled by tankers and get wrecked. So we're gonna start out with the Po-2. We're gonna take all of our bombs. We can carry 4, which is, I guess, decent. It doesn't matter. All right, so hopefully we have a short respawn into it. Winter camouflage, comrade. Oh, we got a friendly Po-2. Po-2 hype. So I think this is arcade, so we don't really have to worry about breaking our wings. So we just want to drop down there as fast as possible. We've already got our landing gear down. Reduce speed. Dude, I remember flying this thing out in RB. And like, it takes forever. It's one of those things where like, if you could kill a high tier tank with this thing, it'd probably be one of the most satisfactory and satisfying kills in the history of War Thunder. The Po-2, man. I remember this was one of my favorite videos I made years and years ago when I found out that it was available, but it was kind of hidden. People were like, what is this plane? Like, and I think I read about it on the forums and was like, there's this Po-2 plane that's hidden. Look at that, my graphics card is already artifacting, which is a shame. I need to get a GTX 1080. Let us see, okay, we got cruisers and some mediums. We're getting, dude, they did good. They capped, no, almost capped it. You kind of need 3 or 4. This would be good to play in a squad of friends, if you can. And there's less tanks than there are planes, which does make it all the better. We got Mr. Wasted Penguins. All right, so we're just gonna run in there. We're not in RB, so we don't have to worry about breaking. Karaju! Now, I wanna go in, I wanna do it Night Witch style. Basically, flying low, and dropping bombs. And since it's arcade, we should have... We have our bombing reticle. Dude, at one point, I don't think this thing had a bombing reticle. Which is crazy. There's some planes some that definitely need bombing reticles. Lags are going... Unfortunately, you don't get the hurricane with the 40s. Now, one thing I want to talk about right now, since we're bombing and we do have the time as we're going slow as all molasses, is the fact that bombing right now in realistic battle tanks, and realistic tank battles, I guess would be a better way to word it, is just shit. Like, you can't do low-flying bombing runs because your bombs blow you up. And I'm not sure if that, like, is that historically accurate? All right, so let's see. 35 seconds on the bombs. Ground unit destroyed. All right. Mr. Potu, Tovarish Thunder. So, since it's going to take a little bit of time, I don't want to dive down and try to cap just yet. Oh, wow. Was that machine gun fire? We are getting hit already. 10 seconds left. It's about time to turn. We're going to build up all the speed we can. This thing just... bleed speed. This LVT is luckily distracted. I don't think it's gonna matter too much. Oh god. Ground unit destroyed? Did we take two out? I wonder if this will count. No, we got one. Look at that. You fly so slow that you'll wreck. Or that, like, when you're crashing, it's not really a crash. It's more of a rough landing. So we got killed by a T-26E. T-26E with armor? Chem off it, mate. So now we're going to take the Lag 3. Now this guy should be the bad boy that gets us, you know, that we can do some pretty decent damage with. The Po-2's fun. But yeah, so bombing definitely needs to get, wait a minute. It doesn't count our kills? It doesn't kill our tank, count our tank kills, but you can see that the points wise, I'm not sure if it's flaps raised. Yes. All right, let's get in here. So that's a T-26E. So there's spaced armor. What's this? This is a fun event. I gotta give a little bit of a congratulations, a job well done to Gaijin. Ooh, we got an LVT is what it is. Huh. We did a little bit of work there. Let's max out them G's and hit him from the other side. This is his side too. Oh. He's chinking back and forth. Try to hit him from, like, up top. Not getting any hit indications. And I'm pretty sure, granted, there's some high angling right there. But we should get something. This one's not the best. Let's try to... You know what, we're gonna go gear down. We're gonna ride this runway here. We gonna slide up down it. Oh, they just used the road. How fun. See, I don't imagine that these are very difficult. Ooh, we got an assist. Nice job. The other lag three got him. What's up, bro? Don't mind me. Now, I'm not sure if we did anything, actually. Oh, we are getting hit. Ooh, that was a shell. There we go. There's our first critical hit with this thing. Cannon is reloading. It's going to take 21 seconds. We've got a hole in our right wing. So here's an idea. This should be fun. I think everybody in the comments, what I would like to see is like ideas for fun battles. Fun, silly battles like this that the community could enjoy and, you know, that there would be prizes for, but kind of to remind everyone that you're playing this game, you should be anyway, for fun. Our 50 cal ran out and all we had was 20 left. We're still flying around. This lag is pretty damn good. But we don't have the points to win this. I don't think anyone's trying to cap. I think we're all trying to kill tanks. Because, I mean, this is one of the best modes to kind of, like, get your first little bit of fun in planes versus tanks. Yellow! Yellow Habibi! All right, we're gonna try the PO2 one more time. It's going to take us a little bit of time to get there. But we will do our best. Oh, you know, I wonder if I could have done the other spawn point. Let's just see real quick. Because that would be worth it. And I'm pretty sure we get, like, infinite respawns. Alright, nope. Respawn base is stuck to bombers, unfortunately. I guess that would be a little unfair. But then again, it's the PO2. Dave, can we get over 200 kilometers? Or will it limit us? No. You can just get over 200. Now, in the game, an RB, this thing would be falling apart. It is not. It's crazy to think, though, that, like, the PO2 in this game has such a problem, like, climbing. And you're like, if it's really this bad, like, how did they use it in real life? Because they used these things up until, like, the Vietnam War. The night witches during World War II used these things to pretty good effect. Granted, they were night bombing raids. And if you haven't read up on the PO2 night witches, really cool stuff. But I know that bombers in War Thunder need to be changed drastically. And I know that we need to have more fun events like this to kind of, like, you know, remind the community about fun. Because you see those people who let the stress and anxiety of the grind, and, you know, in the impatience of the grind, affect their play. And at times you can run into some pretty, pretty salty people. So let's see. We need to cap. That's what we need to do. I'm hoping to get there in time to drop these bombs. I might get shot. But that is the issue when you take the PO2 out. I remember when this was an event plane. I remember when it was like the hidden plane in the, you know, in the very, very early days. Like, they had it in the tech tree, then they kind of took it off, but you still had it if you opened it up. Oh my gosh, I don't even know if we're going to get there. Come on, someone cap it. No one's here. Oh, they're kind of shooting each other down. Well, that's unfortunate. Maybe we'll fly straight. We'll give them the opportunity to hit us. Oh! What a shot. The game was going to end anyway. That was amazing. I don't think we would have gotten there. Look at this. See? Mission failed. Only killed two enemies. Oh, look at that. We're J-ing out. Plane's going up. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was a fun event. So the comments and the questions of the day are, what needs to be changed for bombers in War Thunder? And two, and this is, should be a fun one. The weekends should be fun. It's a weekend video. What kind of more fun game modes can you think of? Just silly ones like this that you could, like, orchestrate in a custom battle. Or even better that, like, have people program them in, you know, by Gaijin. But, I mean, if you look at this event right now, it's pretty fun. I still don't understand why the T-126 is in there. But, you know, reward the premium. I'm not sure. But I know anything with a 50 caliber machine gun or a 20 millimeter with ground and pound rounds, you know, armored target rounds, would be the best one to take out. And I think the LVT, while it doesn't have the best armor, as you can see here. Like, look at that. 12.7. But the effective thickness, you know, when you're coming at crazy angles, is still not that good. But I think we should have done more, but I guess it has so much space. You really got to aim and aim pretty well. So, ladies and gentlemen, that was the Road for the Brave. thank you, Gaijin, for this fun and silly mode. It's a good first attempt, you know. Well, they've implemented floats. This isn't the first time they've done it. They've had a couple of silly game modes, but it's been quite a while since we've seen one. So as it's a holiday weekend, it's a beauty to see it. So, ladies and gentlemen, happy 4th of July weekend, the Independence Day for the United States of America. Hope you guys have a great day. I'm going to go out and swim, boat, and barbecue. That's what America does.